Why do you want to run for mayor?
Well, I don't like the circus that's going on down here right now, and I think that they need some leadership. And as I was saying to David, my track record is that I earned the taxpayers over $1 billion with my initiatives on waste management. When I was chairman of social services, I was able to expand the daycare system and come in $32 million and $9 million, respectively, under budget. Also got paramedic training, which a few months after I visited their EMS headquarters, they told me they'd saved 109 lives. So I think we need to get some. Also, I reorganized the police department, got the first contract, negotiated contract in 8 years with them after 8 years of arbitration. So I also got Dudley Laws to compromise and deal with us in a civil level. He's dealing with police and black community relations, and we never had another demonstration by Dudley after that. So I kind of want to unify the city and provide some leadership to a council that seems to be going off in different directions.
Now, do you live in Toronto at this point, or are you still
in
Toronto?
Yes, I do.
Okay, you moved down to into the city.
Yes.
And what do you think of Rob Ford?
Not much. I think, you know, I think he probably meant well, and a lot of people put faith in him, but I think he's kind of jeopardized the health of the city in many respects. And it's not that people betrayed him. I think he betrayed the people.
Can you? Sorry, sir. You've been around here enough to know that I need you to repeat why you're running from there. I'm sorry. I missed it.
That's okay. No, I think there's definitely a lack of leadership there. And from one of the comments that I get from a lot of people is, you know, their choices so far seem to be Chow or Ford. And which one, you know, some more left-wingers will say, well, I'll go for Chow. Others will say, if that's all I got to choose from, then I'm going to go for Ford. And I think he's jeopardizing the health and safety of the people in the city. So I got a track record that I'm kind of proud of. And as I said to Don and some of the others, I earned the taxpayers over $1 billion with my initiatives in waste management. As chairman of social services, I came in under budget by $32 million and $9 million respectively, but while expanding daycare services in the suburbs and getting paramedic training for our ambulance personnel at the time, which a few months after their training and I visited their headquarters, they told me they'd already saved 109 lives. So when I see the cuts in the ambulance and the slower response, the firefighters being taken off the road, no more proactive police patrols, or at least hardly any. You start to wonder where the city is going. Rob Ford can say he's saving people tax dollars, but for every buck he saves them on the tax roll, they're digging into their pocket to spend $4 or $5 to replace the buck that he saved them. And so, under those circumstances, I think I try and make things a little more interesting.
So where do you stand on the political spectrum?
I've always been kind of a small liberal or small C conservative. But I believe that you have to have decent social programs. Otherwise, you're going to have riots in the streets. And that you have to look after people. But at the same time, you have to be reasonable in terms of how you spend your money. Spend it wisely.
Are you currently retired?
Yes.
How long have you been retired?
9-10 years.
How old are you, sir?
Old enough to know better and young enough to take a chance.
Are you up for a full-time job like mayor? And more than full-time?
Listen, I could outrun anybody in this council, I think. Well, maybe not.
are you still permitted to carry a sidearm? No, that's all done. Okay.
Yeah, that was only for a short time.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Gardner?
Yes.
My name is Natalie. Post.
Hi, Natalie. How are you?
So you're running, you registered for the mayor?
Yes, I just did.
And what's compelling you to do that?
Well, what I see is a lack of leadership here. Also, a lot of comments by people that if they had to choose between a Chow and a Ford, they kind of design themselves that they would have to vote for a Ford. And I know that Olivia was a big spender. I served with her on committees. And I don't want to see us go back, the city go back to the three-wheel spending that Miller had. But you have to have some responsible programs, responsible spending, and be accountable. And part of my background was I chaired Public Works at one time, and my initiatives in public waste, or in public works and waste management, earned the taxpayer over $1 billion. And as chairman of social service, I came in $32 million and $9 million under budget, while expanding the daycare system throughout the suburbs and building an Alzheimer's wing at Cummer Lodge.
Is this during the after the city amalgamated?
Yes. And I also got the union to back off against the training of paramedics at one time. And shortly after visiting them, after they had their training, they told me they'd saved 109 lives. So when I see ambulance response being slowed down because we're short over 200 paramedics, where one paramedic told me 30% of his pay last year was overtime pay. These are all things that need some remedying, because I think the public are being put at much greater risk as a result of the shenanigans in terms of some of the budget cuts going on here.
So what do you think of Rob Ford and his performance as mayor?
I think he's performed poorly. I think that he may have meant well, but I don't think I don't think he takes a look at the broad spectrum of the side effects of some of his comments and some of the cuts. You don't treat every budget the same. You have to take a look at each budget to see whether or not there's merit in what they're saying or where there's not merit. Hi, how are you?
Well, you've been out of the game a long time.
Yes.
A lot of things have changed in the political landscape.
Yes.
Why do you want to get back in the game, and why do you think the public is still interested in it?
Well, because I think, I don't know if the public is interested. I know there's some people that are certainly interested in me, because a lot of them are urging me to get back in here because they like what I did before. And I feel that I have something to offer. So as long as you have something to offer and you're ready, you're ready for the game, why not try to participate?
Any of the games are here in the campaign?
Not yet.
Do you have a campaign manager?
No, this is, I've done this rather, with a lot of urging, but quite a little spontaneously.
Since you left? What have you been doing since you left politics?
Well, basically I've been working from time. I've been retired, but I've been doing the odd job for people in the energy business, but more with alternative energy fuels.
Have you been a lobbyist? Is that what
it is? No, I haven't done any lobbying. I just helped them with some of their work. I've done some work with security analysis, and I've made some speeches on terrorism. So I've been educating myself in some of the fields in which I have a lot of interest.
And when you say spontaneously, did you just wake up today and say?
No, I didn't do that. But getting to the point where you actually go and sign up, it's been, I've been weighing things, yes or no, but anyways, today I said yes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.